Welcome to the official iPad mini review. This is just going to be the full-on review. Last night I did a Ustream live, which was my basic first impressions of the iPad mini. It went alright. I was pretty pleased with the video. So let's go ahead and get into it. At the end of the video, I will be trying out applications. That way I can, you know, give you guys a basis on the performance. So let's go ahead and get into the iPad mini full review. The screen does get a lot of fingerprints. Even with the oleophobic coating that they have on here, it does get a lot of fingerprints. So you may want to go ahead and get a screen protector or get some wipes for it. As you can see in the light there, I'm not sure if you can see the fingerprints, but it does have the oleophobic coating. Even with that, you still get a lot of fingerprints. Also, the back gets fingerprints as well. Smudges, fingerprints. Also, I've noticed the Chris Perillo signature has actually rubbed off. That's okay. I don't mind that, but it would have been nice to keep it on there, but that's okay. It actually rubbed off because I was constantly using it and trying to get a lot of stuff on here for you guys so I can do the review for you. So yeah, basically, make sure you go ahead and get a protector or get some wipes for it, because it does get a lot of fingerprints with the even with the oleophobic coating that they put on here. So make sure you do that. And I'm gonna have to do another clip because my phone here is running out. Alrighty guys, the display is a 7.9 inch measured diagonally. Apple went ahead and just twisted it around from the iPad Classic, which is a 9.7. So the display is a 7.9. Also the pixel per inch, which PPI, is 163, I believe, and the resolution is 1024 by 768, which is something really interesting there, as you go ahead and look at that. Also, let's see, it also uses the same LED as the classic iPad does, so it's the same LED technology as the classic iPad. Alrighty guys, I am going to be talking about the camera on the iPad mini here. It's got two cameras, a FaceTime camera and the main camera, as I call it. It's 1080p EyeSight HD, which is very good, and I may use the camera here, the main camera, for my vlogs. It's also got a 5 megapixel for taking images as well. And the front facing camera here, the FaceTime camera, as you can call it, 720p, 1.2 megapixels. I would not be using it for pictures, and I would only be using it for specifically for FaceTime. This would be my main camera, and as I said, I may use it for vlogs, for videoing some vlogs as well. It's very comfortable in the hands as well. You can hold it in landscape, and that's the way I prefer holding this. You can hold it this way as well. I apologize for the banging upstairs. There's a bunch of kids up there who are disrespectful. Okay, you can hold it like this, and you could also go ahead and keep your hands on the screen without interacting with the applications. So that's something I really like that they incorporated. You could basically, you know, just go ahead and see it's not launching any applications or anything. So that's really cool. The reason why they did that was because how small the bezel is on each side. You can't really hold it without touching the screen. So they went ahead and did that for us, which is really cool. I like that. Like I said, it's very comfortable, well balanced. I prefer holding it in landscape, not in portrait. That's basically my thoughts on the camera and the video, and also the comfortableness of holding the iPad mini, which is very palmable. Guys, very palmable. Can't do that with the iPad 2 or the iPad Classic or whatever you want to call it. Also, you can go ahead and operate all the controls with just one hand, which you could not do with the iPad 2. You could go ahead and hit the on and off or sleep and wake button just with one hand, as you can see there. You can go ahead, and if you want to get to the volume real fast, you can go ahead and operate that as well. As you can see, I'm going to try to do that so you guys can see it. Is it coming up? No, yep. Okay, you can barely see it. But there in the middle, you can probably see that. The up and down volume is easy to get to with one hand while holding the iPad mini. So that's cool. I like that about it. Alright guys, this is the iPad mini. Yes. It is the iPad mini. 23% thinner, 53% lighter than the iPad Classic. Okay, I'm not sure if you can see that well with my stupid iPhone camera. That's pretty thin there, guys, and it's very light as well. The responsiveness is pretty good. Overall, I'm happy with it so far. I got 1 gigabyte left. This is a 16 gigabyte. So I got 1 gigabyte left, and I got pretty high applications, pretty big applications. I got Sketchbook, iMovie, iPhoto, GarageBand, all the big applications that take up a lot of space, basically. I got a couple games. I got a couple things later on at the end of the review I want to show you and run through. That way you guys can get an idea. Yeah, overall, it's very comfortable. I like it. The performance is okay. The responsiveness, there is a little bit of stutter. It's hard to tell for basic, you know, people who don't really look out for that stuff and can't really tell. But like I said, in the end, I will do a more in-depth on that. Battery life is said to have 10 hours. Okay, now that is for the casual user, and for my needs right now, I'm an extreme user. This sucker will be dead by the time I upload my vlog tonight, okay? This sucker will be dead, and it's at 94%, okay? And I just got done charging it. So yeah, I just got a message here, sorry about that. I hate when that happens. I should have turned those notifications off. But I got Siri on here as well. I opted for Siri. Which she works great, and I know I'm referring to her as a woman. It's the program. Siri works great on this. I didn't have her on the iPad 2. I wasn't able to get her on the iPad 2. So, yeah, I'm really, really happy with Siri because I use the Siri program a lot. And I keep getting that. It keeps messing me up. Like I said, very palmable. I'm just doing a small recap. Very palmable. You can get to all the controls very easily, which I'll go over in a minute here, all of where everything is positioned at. Very comfortable, very balanced, portrait landscape. I go for landscape more than portrait. Yeah, so the battery life is decent, not the best for me because it's the iPad mini. Remember, A5 chip, not the A6. So the performance is going to be expected, not as great as the A6. So if you want to do a lot of extreme stuff with your iPad, go for the iPad Retina display. Don't go for the iPad mini because this is for basic, smaller needs. Yes, I did get this for free. Yes, I did win this from Chris Perillo. And yes, I'm happy I have it. And I'm thankful and very grateful for winning. But if I had the money and I went for the iPad mini or the iPad Retina display, I would go for the Retina display because I prefer a bigger processor than the A5 chip. I prefer just the bigger iPad overall. This is more personal. It's more personal than a regular iPad Classic because it is smaller. And when you're watching movies, that's a good thing because it's, you know, kind of more personal and it's in your own zone there. You can watch it. And the video, like I said, the video's fine. It's fine. It's decent. It's not the greatest. But there's not a lot of lag. Which I'm surprised, so far I'm surprised at the lag, okay? There's not a lot of lag, there's not a lot of jumping, but there is some skipping. You can really tell if you're a geek and you look for that sort of thing, but I'll go ahead and just, I'm going to go into the screenshots here.
The first app I want to launch is the camera app to show you where they actually have the camera button, and it's actually right here, right on the side, right-hand side, which I do not like because if you have your hand on the side, you're holding the iPad like this, it will interact with the camera, and also if you accidentally hit that, you take a picture. So, I mean, you'd have to really actually hold it down here at the end instead of holding it here on the right-hand side by the camera button. Now, this is the the FaceTime camera I'm doing. The back camera here, the 1080p, would be a lot better quality, so just to let you guys know, that is the camera. And this will be the video, and as you can see, once again, you have your hand here, you accidentally hit that, and then all of a sudden you're recording. So that's not a good place for the button there. But I do realize why they've done that, and that's fine with me. Now I'm going to go ahead and get out of that, and I want to show you maps. Now this is the responsive. It is pretty responsive. The iPad 2, whenever I would want to launch the maps, I'd have to sit there and wait for it to load, and actually you would see like that little block of screen that you just seen. It's see that little screen that you keep seeing. The stutter is there a little bit, But overall, I am happy with it. It is quite better than the iPad 2. Maybe just the internet connection, I'm not sure. But it does seem a lot better, a lot smoother. But also the iPad 2, I still had the same internet connection. So it is the iPad itself that is better, not the internet connection. As you can see, it's very clear, very fast. No extreme amount of stuttering or delay. But I did have a small amount there. As you can see, the box. So yeah, that's the maps works well in here. The performance is pretty good. There's a little bit of stutter, as you can see. And there's the box that I've told you about. And actually, it would have taken a lot longer on the iPad 2 for that to clear up. So that is the Maps app. And let me go into a different application here. I downloaded SocialLink, which is an awesome application, mainly for the iPhone. But you can also use it for the iPad. Basically, what you do is you go ahead, say there's a iOS device of one of your friends that's nearby, and you want to actually connect with them on Facebook or LinkedIn or Instagram. You can just go ahead and connect automatically through this application. I'll show you how. Go up here, hit next. Then there's all the application or all the social networks that you can connect to with your friends. I'm already connected on Twitter. I'm already signed in, so all I would have to do is hit next. And then what it does is you can link to the nearest iOS device, which may be your friends that's nearby, or you can send them an email. I'll go ahead and hit link. And what it does is it searches for iPhones, iPod touches, or iPads. And if there's a friend nearby who has one of those devices, it'll automatically connect or ask him to connect with your device as well. And there's no one nearby, so I'm just going to exit out of that. Now you can connect all these accounts at once. Instead of connecting Twitter, you can connect all at once. I'd rather prefer doing just the Twitter for now until I get more experience with that. This is going to be a video on where everything is positioned, the buttons and controls and whatnot, and the connectors. Here is the Lightning connector, which I am very new to. Alongside each side of the Lightning connector is the audio speakers. They're very good speakers as far as I can tell. On the side here, there is the silent mode in the volume up and down. On the top is the headphone jack, 3.5 millimeter. In the middle, as you can see, that little slot there is the microphone, actually. And then on that side is the power button on and off and the sleep. There's the camera, 1080p video, along with 5 megapixel. Let's turn it over to
you guys. Here is the 720p FaceTime camera along with the 1.2 megapixel. This is the FaceTime camera. Now we go to the bottom of it, and here we find the home button. The home button is placed actually right above the Lightning adapter. And that is basically the front and the back of the iPad mini. Front and the back. That is the run-through of where everything is located on the iPad mini.
Alright guys, thank you for watching the iPad mini review. Make sure you go down below in the descriptions and check out the link that I provided.
So let's go ahead and get into the iPad mini full review. The screen does get a lot of fingerprints. Even with the oleophobic coating that they have on here, it does get a lot of fingerprints. So you may want to go ahead and get a screen protector. Also, I've noticed the Chris Perillo signature has actually rubbed off. That's okay. I don't mind that, but it would have been nice to keep it on there, but that's okay. It actually rubbed off because I was constantly using it and trying to get a lot of the iPad mini. It went alright. I was pretty pleased with the video. So let's go ahead and get into it. At the end of the video, I will be trying out applications. That way I can, you know, give you guys a basis on the performance detector or get some wipes for it. As you can see in the light there, I'm not sure if you can see the fingerprints, but it does have the oleophobic coating. Even with that, you still get a lot of fingerprints. Also, the back gets fingerprints as well, smudges, fingerprints. Guys, welcome to the official iPad mini review. This is just going to be the full-on review. Last night I did a Ustream live, which was my basic first impression.